It's been almost 500 years since Hernán Cortés, fleeing from Cuba in March of 1519, began the invasion of our lands. He came here without the permission of the viceroy, and even less so with the permission of the king. The penalty for conquering lands, as they call the invasions, was the death penalty. So he, to save his neck, invented stories that he wrote in his letters of relation to the king, saying that he had received voluntarily the kingdom and our lands. Lies. He invaded, killed, raped, he made a treacherously attack, and forcibly he seized our territory and subdued the native population. 500 years after, we must revive our historical memory. In March 12, 1519, the host of Hernán Cortés arrived to the lands of Tabasco, and thus the Spanish invasion started against our lands, against our communities, and the brutal genocide of our people. In 1519, there were around 25 to 30 million of inhabitants in what was called the Anahuac, and by 1651 there was only 1,200,000 inhabitants, victim to the smallpox, of the war of extreme exploitation to which they were subjected by the cruel Spanish invaders. And there began the colonialism, the looting of our lands, of our wealth, the death, the destruction. Our culture was devastated, but its roots remain. Today, 500 years after the invasion, these powerful, strong roots begin to bear fruit in the fight for the full sovereignty of our country and for the end of the looting of neocolonialism. Because after having suffered 300 years of colonialism, today we are suffering for neocolonialism. And today foreigners are still taking our gold, our silver, our oil, our wealth, and exploiting Mexican workers as much as possible. That these 500 years be a sign of hope in the fight that will release us of the colonialism and neocolonialism. Five hundred years ago, our native communities developed a great culture. They had zoos and botanical gardens, apiaries. 200 years earlier than in Europe, they had aqueducts, water works, and they managed their water correctly. The native communities developed advanced medicine. The environment was healthy. They had great architectural works, and they were city planners by excellence. The urban layout of Mexico City today has pre-cautemic origins. Education was universal and free, and healthcare for all was also free. There was no lack of jobs for anybody. They were very hygienic people. They also developed art and culture, great sculptures, great murals. They had food self-sufficiency. Even in the cities, each carpool sowed corn, beans, zucchini, peppers. They had enough food. The diet was healthy and full of proteins. They also consume insects and spirulina algae that the lake produced. The native people lived in communities. A key to the harmony that they achieved was this life in community, where everyone worked for each one, and each one for everyone. They were communities that developed astronomy in a magnificent way, far superior to what they had in Europe. We are saying that about 500 years ago, here there was a great civilization. Lies that they were savages. Savages and bloodthirsty were the invaders that came out of the jails of Spain and committed an atrocious genocide in our land. Hernán Cortés used to bribe everybody and his soldiers with gold. He was the first one who started buying elections. It's time to raise our land again. It's time to learn from the native communities and rescue the best of our culture. 500 years ago, Hernán Cortés began an invasion of our lands. By blood and fire imposed the Spanish rule, enslaved our native communities, and began the looting of our wealth, establishing the colonialism. Let's commemorate this tragic 500th anniversary by rescuing this sacred truth and claiming the rights of the indigenous communities and the people of Mexico. We suffered 500 years of corruption. The original communities were very strict and did not allow corruption. For example, if a judge of those that used to be in the market favored one of the merchants to the detriment of another, accepting a bribe, this judge was sentenced to death. The officials were elected by merit, and there was not intense personal desire to get rich. In general, society suffered the well-being of the community 500 years ago with the brutal invasion that Hernán Cortés began. The stealing and looting started. Hernán Cortés, as we can read from history, bribed with gold all his close friends, and the king of Spain accepted anything in return of ships full of gold to get even richer. The king sold the positions, and the mayor who bought these functions advocated to get rich. There the corruption began to unleash. 500 years later, the Mexican people, fed up of the corruption, is searching for a system in the center of which is the well-being of the person, of the society, and not the enrichments of a few. In March of 1519, Hernán Cortés began the invasion of our lands, of Anáhuac. It was not an arrival of the Spanish. It was not a conquest, it was a brutal invasion, where there was a clash of weapons, made of stone, of wood, of bone, non-lethal weapons, because our ancestors in war didn't seek to kill, but to take prisoners. With European weapons, savage people that had developed a large arms industry, cannons, muskets, steel swords, helmets, armors, horses. The brutal confrontation caused the domination of our people. We will not forget 500 years later of this injustice. We have to awaken our historical memory